Hello friends, welcome back, hearty welcome to you. Let us look at this problem. We have to find out what is the value of cosecant of 10 plus cosecant of 50 minus of cosecant of 70. What is the value? Is it equal to 4, 6, 8 or minus 6? We have been given couple of options. So this is a little bit advanced level example. When you are new to trigonometry, maybe you can try this after some time once you are very comfortable how to use the formulas. Okay, let's go ahead and try to solve this now. Fine. So cosecant is really not interesting to me. So what I really like is sine and cos, because we know so many formulas related to sine and cos. So let me do one thing straightforward. Let me change that into sine by saying that 1 by sine 10 plus 1 by sine 50 minus 1 by sine 70. These are degrees, even I forget. Now can I take LCM of these two and write it down as sine 50 into sine 70? Here it is sine 70 minus sine 50 degrees. We will leave this 1 by sine 10 like this only for some more time. Now what will be our next step? Next step is we can apply the transformations. We can write down 1 by sine 10 plus sine c minus sine d. Formula is 2 cos c plus d by 2 sine c minus d by 2. So can I write down 2 cos 70 plus 50 by 2 and sine of 70 minus 50 by 2 divided by what we have there, sine 50, multiply that with sine 70. Now that's equal to 1 by sine 10 plus numerator, I have 70 plus 50 by 2 is cos 60. So can I write down 2 into cos 60, that is 1 by 2, into sine 70 minus 50 by 2 from the earlier step, that is sine 10, divided by sine 50 and sine 70. Now 2 and 2 will cancel. Next step will be 1 by sine 10 plus sine 10 divided by sine 50 into sine 70. Now can we take LCM for this now? For all of them together, the denominator will be sine 10, sine 50, sine 70, and the numerator will be sine 50 sine 70 plus sine square 10. That's equal to, now sine 50 sine 70, can I write it as sine of 60 minus 10, and next is sine of 60 plus 10 plus sine square 10 divided by sine 10 sine 50 sine 70 can be written as sine of 10 into sine of 60 minus 10 into sine of 60 plus 10, which is equal to, now this is sine of a minus b into sine of a plus b, so I can write it as sine square a minus sine square b, that is sine square 60 minus sine square 10 plus sine square 10 divided by, now coming to this formula, sine a into sine of 60 minus a into sine of 60 plus a is equal to 1 by 4 of sine of 3a. What is a value here? A value is 10. So this will become 1 by 4 sine 30 degrees. Now we'll simplify this in the next step. That's equal to, we have numerator sine square 10 cancels. We are left out with sine square 60. And the denominator we have 1 by 4 into sine 30. Now how this formula came, I'll just explain you right now. So substituting the values, we have root 3 by 2 whole square by 1 by 4 into 1 by 2. Simplification, we get 6. Now two things we have used here, new formulas. Sine of a minus b into sine of a plus b is sine square a minus sine square b. Another formula is sine a into sine 60 minus a into sine 60 plus a equal to 1 by 4 sine 3a. Now these two formulas I'll explain you how we can arrive at them. Now let's look at this. We'll try to first prove this one, because that will be useful to prove the second one too. So let's go now. First we'll write down sine of a plus b into sine of a minus b. I have to prove equal to sine square a minus sine square b. What is sine of a plus b formula? We know sine a cos b plus cos a sine b. That we want to multiply with sine of a minus b, that is sine a cos b minus of cos a sine b. Now is it in the form of a plus b into a minus b? Can I write it as a square minus b square? So sine a cos b whole square minus cos a sine b whole square. Now is that equal to sine square a cos square b, sine square a cos square b minus cos square a sine square b? But we want our answer to be in terms of sine only, so we'll convert cos into sine. Can I write down sine square a into 1 minus sine square b minus 1 minus sine square a into sine square b? Now open the bracket, you get sine square a minus sine square a sine square b minus sine square b plus sine square a sine square b. Now sine square a sine square b cancels, you get your answer sine square a minus sine square b. That's a one formula which is also useful to solve the next proof, that is sine a into sine 60 plus a into sine 60 minus a equal to 1 by 4 sine 3 a. Now how to do that? For that again we leverage whatever the formula we just used now. We'll leverage for this particular two the formula what we learned now. So we'll write down sine a into sine of a plus b into sine of a minus b. Just now we learned that is sine square a minus sine square b. So can I write down sine square 60 minus sine square a? Now let's simplify this. Sine a into sine square 60 is 3 by 4 minus sine square a. Take LCM, that's equal to sine a into 3 minus 4 sine square a divided by 4. Is it nothing but equal to 3 sine a minus 4 sine cube a divided by 4, which is equal to 1 by 4 into sine 3 a. So these formulas, which are very important in the exam, in the problems, you can directly use these formulas so that you can solve the problem easily. Now let's go back and try to have a recap of this particular problem. We have been asked to find out what is the value of cosecant 10 plus cosecant 50 minus cosecant of 70. First we have transformed them into sine, because we are not comfortable with cosecant, cot and secant. We know formulas in sine, secant, sine and cos more easily. So we converted them into sine. Then we have applied the formula. We have applied transformations sine 70 minus sine 50. After that we have applied the formula sine a plus b into sine a minus b, and in the denominator we got sine a sine 60 minus a sine 60 plus a, where we can use the formula 1 by 4 sine 30. So we have leveraged that particular two formulas and we are able to solve this and understand that cosecant 10 plus cosecant 50 minus cosecant 70 is equal to 6. So how we have solved that is explained here. We have sine of a plus b into sine of a minus b equal to sine square a minus sine square b. We have sin a, sin 60 plus a into sin 60 minus a is equal to 1 by 4 sin 3a. Similarly, you have cos a, cos 60 plus a into cos 60 minus a. Do you have any formula? Try it out. All of these are important formulae which are useful to solve the problems.